Oh, he leans Republican. Okay. Sorry, I was trying to reach Ryan.
Sheila Jamison, and I love being a volunteer. As a New Yorker, and particularly in this political season, I feel it's very important to give back.
I do dance parade, Museum of Reclaimed Urban Space, Reading Partners, Marquee Studios, and Swing Left. I grew up in a family, and more so a community that was involved in just helping each other. We lived in Ocean Hill, Brownsville. We lived in a brownstone. All of the families knew each other. We would look out for each other's kids. And my parents were people who weren't formal volunteers. Like, they didn't work for, you know, formal volunteer organizations, but they were very active in their civic lives, whether it was through their church or through our school. My mother was very active in the teacher strike in Ocean Hill, Brownsville back in 1967, 1968. By my parents being involved in civic activities, it has inspired me to try to continue that tradition.
I've always been empathetic to suffering of people and how policies affect people's day-to-day lives, and empowering myself and empowering other people to make changes.
I don't want to live in a society where children can't read, or where senior citizens are lonely,
or where history is trampled on while people go to their bottomless brunches and throw up in the streets.
I have lived in the East Village since 1991. Back when I first moved here and beyond, like in the 80s, the East Village was an abandoned wasteland. At least from the outside it seemed that way, but there was a very vibrant artist community, music community, and political community thriving here, and it was the actions of those groups that made the East Village such a desirable place to live. I value the importance of tenants' rights, I value the importance of reclaimed space, and I value the importance of sustainable living. For close to 30 years, I worked in public relations in music and film and television. I found it difficult to be a volunteer when I worked in the entertainment business because my hours were long. Evenings, weekends, a lot of travel. Even if I wanted to volunteer, I didn't have the energy. And then I found myself laid off in 2011. And I was watching a show on Channel 13 about how to find a job, and there was a guy on, and he said, the best way to find a job is to just start working.
I love museums, I love dance, I love art. So those were the areas in which I, you know, did research to find a place to volunteer.
The Museum of Reclaimed Urban Space is a history museum that is archiving the social activism that gave rise to community gardens and squats in this community. As a longtime resident of the East Village, it's been dismaying to watch all of these changes occur, and everything is happening so quickly, and people don't have any idea of the struggle and the sweat equity that went in to making this neighborhood what it is. Marquee Studios is an art studio in Dumbo that trains teaching artists to work with children with special needs.
There are some kids who are paralyzed from the neck down, who are able to use their eyes to work with some software and a computer program, and they make stuff that's just so heartfelt.
Swing Left was an organization that started right after the elections to try to influence the 2018 midterm elections, which generally most American people don't participate in. And this year it seems very important that we swing the House left. My role with Swing Left was to phone bank, which is something I had never done before. And it was very tricky because people don't want to receive these calls, myself included. Reading Partners is a volunteer program where adults are paired with children who are having trouble reading at different levels. I care about literacy in general because books were important to me as a kid. They helped develop my imagination and my character, and I'd like to be able to return the favor to a kid who's struggling with reading. The Dance Parade is a nonprofit organization that was founded in 2006 to combat the cabaret laws. Dance Parade Day is like one of the best days in New York City. People come from all over the world, literally, to express themselves through dance in the streets of New York. The most phenomenal part of it is a lot of people don't all speak the same language, but they all unite through dance in some way. The first year I did Dance Parade, that was probably the best day of my life. It was such a spiritual experience, and then it rained on us, and the DJ put on rain music, and then it stopped raining, and we said it was because we were dancing, so that was a good one. Even though I'm working now, I find time to still volunteer because I've been very careful to select things that are easily accessible. They have hours that are flexible and I can kind of pick and choose when I can do my service. And also things that I'm honestly passionate about. Everyone has an hour to do some volunteer work. An hour a month, an hour a week, even an hour a year makes a difference.
There are some challenges in volunteering. There are some situations where you feel like you're not really making a difference or you're not getting through, and it can be frustrating. But it's still worthwhile, because for each 100 times you may fail, that one time you get through, it's really very satisfying.
Volunteering affects everyone. There's a you in volunteer.
Yay! They had 4 votes for Ossoff in this one house. Yes. Strong Ossoff. Save and next.
I'm not going to Brooklyn, the Bronx, or the Queens. So whatever needs y'all have in those places, you're on your own, because girlfriend's not coming.